Uniswap is one of the most popular decentralized applications, or dApps, that allows for you to swap thousands of assets between each other in a decentralized manner. And you can use your Zengo wallet to securely swap between these assets. So we'll show you how to do this, and the best way to do it is to start on your desktop. So let's go to Zengo.com. You can see that I'm already there. And you're going to sign into your Zengo wallet onto Zengo Desktop. So I'm going to go down here to log in. Click on it. And the easiest way to do this is by scanning with your QR code. So you can see I've got my phone right here. I'm going to open the camera, zoom in, click, and it'll say, are you trying to log into Zengo on your desktop? Yes, I am. I'm going to swipe to the right. Yes, this was me. And now I've securely logged into Zengo Desktop and I am connected. What you can see on my mobile device is the same thing as what you can see on Zengo Desktop. Now, one of my favorite parts of Zengo Desktop is what we call top dApps. You can see here down on the left, we have links to some of the most popular decentralized applications. Now, if you go to Google to find these dApps on your own, sometimes those links are fake. It's really important to make sure that you're signing into and clicking on the correct link. We've done the work to make sure that at least through Zengo's top dApps, these are the links that you should be clicking on in order to get to where you want to go. And you can see right here, Uniswap is the top option. We'll do more videos talking about some of these other options in the future. So click on Uniswap, and it's gonna pull up a separate tab. And the first thing that you wanna do is you want to connect. So you can see over here, it says connect. You're gonna tap on connect, and you're gonna tap on WalletConnect. And so we're going to be using WalletConnect with the Zengo wallet to connect to Uniswap. So I'm inside of my Zengo wallet, and you can see over here, hold on, let me pull this over. You can see right here, this is an image for scanning with WalletConnect. So I'm going to tap on that. And I'm going to scan this QR. It's already picked it up. It sees that I'm already trying to connect to Uniswap. You can see that Uniswap is supported on a number of chains in layer twos, right? Base, Optimism, Arbitrum, BNB, Polygon, and of course the Ethereum layer one. I'm gonna tap on connect. And now I am connected. And it will automatically see what my address is and what I have inside of my wallet. Today, I wanna do a very simple swap between Ethereum and USDT. So let's see, I've got some ETH in my wallet. I've got a number of other assets as well. Maybe what I'll do is a swap between, let's see, ETH on layer one and USDT on layer one. So let's find ETH there, and I'm going to select the token. I'm going to tap in USDT. And let's say I want to, you can do it in terms of ETH terms or in terms of USDT terms. Let's just swap $10. So I'm going to do it down here. I want to receive $10, and we'll auto-populate how much it costs in terms of ETH. So it looks like I'll be sending about $10.04, and I'll be receiving $10. So now I'll tap on review. It's showing me again what I'm swapping and what I'm receiving. It's going to show me how much it costs. It costs about $1 because we're swapping on Ethereum's layer one, so the gas fee is going to be higher than a layer two. I'm going to tap on swap and confirm in my wallet. So my Zengo wallet is already pulling this up. It's gonna show me a transaction simulation, basically what I'm getting and what I should be receiving to make sure that I am doing what I expect to be doing. Let's look at it together. So I'm sending ETH, about $10.59. I'm gonna click here, and I'm going to be getting about $10 of USDT. Excellent. Now that I'm done reviewing, right, the amount, the network fee, the network, I'm just gonna slide to confirm. And now I'll wait. Now, because we're doing this on Ethereum's layer one, it could take a few minutes before I see the transaction happen. But you can see here that it says that it's currently swapping. If I tap on this or click on it, it'll pull up Etherscan, right? It's like Google for the blockchain. It'll tell me what's going on. Success. You can see that it's already confirmed the transaction.